So another terminology is there, which is, hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Navya, could you able to see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. So next is mass specific gravity. Mass specific gravity means the word itself indicates we will be considering the total mass. Whereas in the previous case, we will be considering the density of only solids. So soil particles density we will be considering, not the density of total soil mass. Okay. So whereas in case of mass specific gravity, I will be considering the total density, bulk density will be taken. So rho by rho w will give me mass specific gravity. So this is mass specific gravity. Okay, whereas this is specific gravity of solids. Another one specific gravity is also there, which is specific absolute specific gravity. So what is absolute specific gravity? See, ikkada em teeskunnam ante density of soil. So the entire system is being considered.
Hello. Ma'am, you've been muted, ma'am. Hello. Hello.
Hello, ma'am. Hello.
Hello Navya, could you able to see the window? One note window. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
So now we will see another specific gravity, which is absolute specific gravity. So how to represent absolute specific gravity? Here, the total soil is being mentioned, whereas in mass specific gravity. Whereas in case of absolute specific gravity, the solids density is taken. Even in this solids density also, some spaces are being occupied by air mass. See, manam soil matto oven la petti dry chestunnam. Okay, so then all the water vapor evaporates, but still the gaps in between the soil grains will be occupied by air mass. So in case of absolute specific gravity, even that air position or air's occupancy is being neglected, we will be considering the absolute density of solids. So absolute density of solids divided by unit weight of water gives us absolute specific gravity. Of all the three specific gravity, absolute specific gravity is more accurate, but in general purpose and general usage, we will be using only the specific gravity which is mentioned here. Okay, so G is widely used, right? Hello.
Yes,
shall we move further?
Yes,
now we have seen specific gravities. One more relationship I will give you. So relationship between air content and percentage air voids. How will we represent percentage air voids? N A.
N A.
Okay. So how to represent air content? A, C. Right? So what is the relation between NA and AC? So NA means percentage air voids. Percentage air voids is equal to porosity into air content. Okay. So NA is equal to N into AC. Just remember this relationship also. Okay. And this is one relationship. Next relationship is relationship between degree of saturation, void ratio, water content, and specific gravity. This is a very important relationship. If there is any problem from unit one, one way or the other, this relationship will be used. Okay, if any question is asked from three-phase system, you have to remember this relationship. This is nothing but SE is equal to WG. Not going to give you the derivations and all, just remember the relationship. The product of degree of saturation into void ratio is equal to water content into specific gravity. Just remember this relationship also. This is very, very important relationship. Okay. This is very important relationship. Just make a note of it. Fine. Now, few more formulae are there, which are quite important in relation with this three-phase system, which is gamma D. Okay. So, gamma D in terms of gamma W is given as G gamma W divided by 1 plus E. Okay. So, dry unit weight equal to G gamma W by 1 plus E. In the same way, if you wish to know bulk unit weight, then what are you supposed to do? Dry unit weight gamma D, whatever you have computed, into 1 plus W. What is W here? Hello?
Water content.
Very good. Water content. So, bulk unit weight is computed, dry unit weight is computed. Now, gamma saturated. So, gamma saturated is computed using the formulae G gamma W into 1 plus W whole divided by, this is gamma W in the suffix, okay, E W suffix only, divided by 1 plus E. Okay, this is a formula for calculating saturated unit weight. Suppose if you wish to know just bulk unit weight, you are not calculating dry unit weight. Appude em cheyalante G gamma W 1 plus SE by 1 plus E ani vastadi. So that is not required. You just remember G gamma W by 1 plus E and then multiply it with 1 plus W. Then you will get bulk unit weight formula. Okay. So, just make a note of them. Shall I move further? Hello?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. And next unit weight is submerged unit weight. So, for submerged unit weight, the formula is G minus 1 by, G minus 1 into gamma W divided by 1 plus E. See, already you have remembered two formulae. Naki formulae gurtu pettukovalani ishtam ledhu. Appude em cheyachu? You know, right? Gamma submerged entama? Gamma saturated minus gamma W. Ante kada? So, just to subtract these two formulae and these two RHs. Appude meeku gamma submerged formula vachesi. Okay. So, you no need to remember a separate formula for gamma submerged. Okay. So, these are all regarding unit weights and some specific gravities. Okay. So, now The next relationship which we are going to discuss is relative density. See, in the field, if you measure the density of sand or density of gravel, you cannot claim that is it in the densest state or is it in the loosest state. So you should know how densely the system is being packed. To measure that denseness, we are using the terminology relative density. So how to measure relative density? So there is an experimental procedure to measure relative density. Here, for exam point of view, we'll be discussing only the formulae. So relative density RD is given by E max minus E natural divided by E max minus E minimum into 100. See, there is a sand which is taken from the field. So, or else you imagine that you have gone to a beach. Okay, and then you have collected some sand. So if you pour it into a container, okay, so just you are standing here and then you are dropping the soil just into this container. Then the soil will get filled up inside this container. Okay, up to here. The same quantity of soil, just, So just to take 1 minute. Just take the container of similar size and then pour it at some height. Okay, konjam height lo nunchi just to drop the soil sample. Then what happens? Same amount of soil. So suppose ippudu oka 1 kg soil undanuko. Same 1 kg of soil, just drop from some certain height into the container. Then what happens? The soil will not fill up to the top of the container. Kada? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Because it will be tightly packed. Whereas here, the soil will be loosely packed. Then if you give some tapping to this container, then it will resume back to this level. Kada? So loose ga okati pour chesthe oka volume occupy chesiddi, whereas if you compact it, then it will resume some other volume. So appudu same soil will have different void ratios. So what is relative density? So relative density is given by the formulae E max minus E natural divided by E max minus E minimum. So what is E max? E max means maximum void ratio of the soil sample. Okay, so the same soil which you have collected from the beach, so that soil's maximum void ratio. So there is one procedure to pour the soil sample at certain height. So I was specified height lo nunchi pour chesetappudu enta sample ostundo aa sample tho void ratio enta ni measure cheyandi, e value, that is e maximum. Then the sample will be existing in the beach, no? So in that natural condition, measure its natural void ratio. So that is, that gives its E natural. So void ratio of the soil in its natural state. So then again, maximum void ratio minus E minimum. E minimum ante enti? Just give some vibrations or tapping to this container. Then what happens? The volume reduces and the pore spaces inside the soil will become smaller, no? సో అన్ని బాగా దగ్గర వచ్చేస్తుంది, సాయిల్ గ్రెయిన్స్ అంతా చాలా దగ్గర వచ్చేసాక వాల్యూమ్ విల్ చేంజ్ ఆర్ వాల్యూమ్ విల్ డిక్రీస్, రైట్? దెన్ ఆబ్వియస్లీ వెన్ వాల్యూమ్ డిక్రీసెస్ వాయిడ్ రేషియో విల్ ఆల్సో డిక్రీస్. ఓకే, సో సాయిల్ బాగా టైట్లీ ప్యాక్డ్ అవుతుంది, అప్పుడు వాయిడ్ రేషియో చాలా తక్కువ ఉంటుంది. సో దాట్ ఇండికేట్స్ మినిమం వాయిడ్ రేషియో. సో కంప్యూట్ మ్యాక్సిమం, మినిమం అండ్ న్యాచురల్ వాయిడ్ రేషియోస్. దాన్ని మళ్ళీ ఈ రిలేషన్షిప్లో సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేయండి. Then you can find out relative density. Okay, so even the densest soil cannot exist in just 100% relative density. Okay, so if you manually try to achieve relative density, you can achieve up to 85 to 90% relative density achieve cheyadame chaala kashtam. For that itself, you have to give huge amount of vibration. then only you can achieve somewhere around 85% of relative density. So if relative density chala ekku unte, you will be calling the soil in a highly dense state. Okay, so relative density 10% 20% unte, the soil is in its loosest state. Okay, so up to here we have seen the properties, few index properties of soil. Okay, so now we will move on to the consistency limits. Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Would you able to follow?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Am I boring? Yes, ante matra em chestar ma'am antara?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So now we will see what is consistency limit. So consistency ante, what is consistency? Be consistent antaru kada. So consistent ante enti? See, you are planning to go for a movie, okay, and one of your friend is coming and telling that no, we will go, just go for a bike ride. Okay, then your mind will be wavering or oscillating. Shall we go for a bike ride or shall we go for a movie? Okay, so consistent ante enti, being in one state or being firm. Okay, so ala gattiga unda, gattiga ante enante firm ga undedi. Okay, so whenever you decide something, you will be doing that. Okay, so after BTech I'll be pursuing a job, ante you have to be consistent in that. So after BTech I will be pursuing my higher studies, so be consistent in that. So after BTech I will be pursuing MBA, and you have to be consistent in that. You should not waver up your mind. So that is what being consistent. So what is consistency limit in terms of soil? So consistency means degree of firmness. So is that soil is in a moldable state, or is that the soil is in a very solid state, or is that soil is in a liquid state? Okay, so that determines its consistency, and this consistency limits are only related to fine grain soil. Okay, so what is coarse grained and what is fine grain soil, we will be discussing just for third year students I am telling, in the soil classification. As of now, just remember the soil particles which are less than 75 micron size and possess certain degree of plasticity or containing clay minerals are called fine grained soil. Kada? Am I right? So less than 75 micron undali, then particle sizes chuste ela undalante less than 75 micron undali, and also it must contain some clay minerals. Okay, so clay minerals unte appudu adi cohesion kuda ostadi. Okay, so as of now just remember, fine grain soil means the particles which are less than 75 micron, and this consistency limits are always related to fine grain soil. Okay, so there are different way to measure this consistency limits. Okay, and there are different levels of consistency limits, and how will you decide the consistency limits of soil? Based on which parameter? Hello? The consistency means firmness. So soil hard ga unda, soft ga unda, or is it in a liquid state? You just imagine a clay, okay, a dry clay. If you pour little amount of water, it will be in different state. If you pour more amount of water, then it will be almost like chocolate milkshake kada alai poyti. So if you keep it inside oven for one or two days, then it will become a harder mass. Okay, then it will be almost like a stone. Okay, that is what I am trying to picturize here. So now tell me. Okay, stiffness or firmness. Now tell me, how is this consistency is changing with relation to which parameter? Which parameter of soil? నేను ఇప్పుడు డిస్క్రైబ్ చేసేటప్పుడు ఏ పారామీటర్ ని వెరీ చేస్తుంది? వెరీ గుడ్. సో కన్సిస్టెన్సీ లిమిట్ ఇస్ టోటలీ రిలేటెడ్ టు వాటర్ కంటెంట్ ఆఫ్ సాయిల్. ఓకే, సో హౌ ది వాటర్ కంటెంట్ ఆఫ్ సాయిల్, సో బేస్డ్ ఆన్ ది వాటర్ కంటెంట్ వీ విల్ బి స్టడీయింగ్ ద డిఫరెంట్ కన్సిస్టెన్సీ లిమిట్. ఓకే, సో లెట్ మీ డ్రా అ గ్రాఫ్ హియర్. On the x-axis, I am going to represent water content. Okay, and on the y-axis, I am going to represent its volume. Okay, so for initially certain amount of water content, the volume of, since I am going to describe soil, right, soil is something which has definite volume kada, so volume of soil will be like this. Oka just oka clay teeskunnaru ma, oka dry state la clay teeskunnaru, so during Vinayak Chaturthi you might have brought some amount of clay, no, for preparing idol. Okay, such kind of clay you have taken. So for final year students, you might have already seen clay during your laboratory session. Okay, so ala oka clay teeskunnaru, so up to certain amount of water content, it will be in its harder form only, it will be in its harder condition up to certain amount of water content. Beyond certain limit, okay, so this, so if you add few more amount of water, then it becomes soft. Okay, so up to here you can say that chala gatti ga undindi, hard ga undindi, so this indicates solid state. Up to this solid state, how much ever amount of water you add, there will not be any change in the volume, it just takes that water, that's it. Okay, and that water content up to which there is no change in its volume is known as shrinkage limit, WS. And beyond that limit, if you add few more amount of water to your clay dough, whatever you brought from the shop or whatever you have taken from the field, if you add few more amount of water, it assumes some semi solid state, so semi solid ka avutundi. Okay, so beyond, so it will be in a semi solid state, so appude enti, it is not in a loose state, but it is not in a harder state, it is bit moldable. Okay, not totally moldable. So after, and this water content is known as plastic limit. At certain point of time, so here you can just change its shape, so the clay shop lo nunchi techar kada, then ila koncham water pose ila ala kalpachu ante, so in just a semi solid state, but you cannot make any figure out of it, so evaina oka shape ledha evaina oka picture oka ball em cheyaledu, just you can change its structure, that's it. So structure in the sense physical ga kanapada macro structure cheptunna, so just a clay mass ila undante, you can just squeeze it or do something ante, kani a shape kadi raadu, so that is what I meant as semi solid state. So up to certain, at suddenly, at certain water content, which is represented by the letter WP, so plastic water content, you can achieve a certain state that you can mold it into any definite figure. So if you wish to make a flower, you can make out of flower. So if you make it like a square, if you wish to make a cube out of it, you can make a cube out of it. So if you wish to roll it into a thread, you can make a thread out of it. Okay. So that state of water content is known as plastic limit. So the minimum water content at which you can change its, or you can mold it into any definite shape. Okay. And if you leave it as such, it will not get back to its original shape. Okay. So nenu oka container laga chestunnanu. Suppose if I make a part out of it, so it retains that part shape as such. Okay, it will not get back to its original state. So evaina okati original state ki raakapothe dani em cheptaru? If I deform something and if it is not getting back to its original state, how am I call it?
Permanent deformation.
Permanent deformation, in other words, if I deform something, if it is getting back, apde em cheptamo? I am deforming something.
Plastic material.
Elastic. And if it get back, then it is elastic. Kada? So get back aithe elastic antamo. So if it does not get back, dani plastic antam.
Plastic.
So here WP indicates plastic limit. So the water content at which you can make the soil into any moldable state. Okay. So the minimum water content with which you can mold the soil sample to any shape. Right. And it can take some deformation. Okay. So appudu aa shape chesetappudu meer emo oka press chesarante aa shape alage assume ayipoyindi. Before getting it dry, if you disturb it, so appudu aa deformation alage undipoyindi. And you can mold it to any shape. Okay, that is the beauty of the plastic water content. Okay, so naaku ee water content kuda nachaledu. I will be keep on adding few more amount of water. Okay, so ee water content ni ila nenu increase chestha unna kuda my soil mass will be still in a plastic state only up to certain extent. So nenu inka baaga motta neel posestunna appude em ayyindi. If I add even more amount of water, then what happens? Hello. If I add even more amount of water, then what happens? See, here the soil is in some moldable form, so I could make some thread out of it, I could make any shape out of it. Em aina chestunnanu. So beyond that also, if I keep on adding water, so water content ni increase chestu vastunnanu. Okay. Then what happens? Hello?
Liquid state.
Liquid.
So if I keep on adding water, more amount of water, then it assumes a liquid state. Okay. So now you just see. Your simple clay has four different states. So solid state, where there is no change in volume at all with the addition of water, then semi solid state, then plastic state, and then finally liquid state. And the minimum water content at which your soil starts flowing, dani liquid limit anta. So liquid ante enti? What is liquid? Liquid is a kind of matter which flows, kada?
Yes,
and which will not take any shear load. Dani shear strength aithe zero untadi liquid. So the material which flows is a fluid, and in specific, if it does not take any shear load, then we will claim that as liquid, kada? And see, now we got four different states. Okay, now we in relation to this diagram, you can see the y-axis lay on the volume, okay, and in x-axis water is there. So if you remember this drawing, you can define all the consistency limits. So first one is, shall we go start from liquid limit or shall we start from shrinkage limit?
Shrinkage limit.
Shrinkage limit nunchi start chestama? Okay. Fine. So now, could you define what is shrinkage limit? You just remember the story of this clay. So you are keep on adding water. So how to represent, describe this WS? WS need describe cheyamantunna. How can you describe it? See, liquid limit aina, plastic limit aina, shrinkage limit aina, water content of soil, that's it. But in different amounts. Okay. Now just describe me what is shrinkage limit.
Where the soil changes from solid state to semi-solid state.
Water content at which the solid changes from solid state to semi-solid state. That is one definition. So otherwise, I can claim that shrinkage limit is the water, maximum water content. Okay. So maximum water content up to which there will not be any significant change in volume of soil. Okay. So maximum water content up to which there will not be any significant change in the volume of soil with the addition of water. Okay, so for example, okay, soil to shrinkage limit 10% ani teeskuntam. Okay, so if I add a water content less than 10% to that soil, so okay, 8% water content add chestunna a soil chala dry state lo undi, a dry state soil meeda 8% water content add chestunna appude em ayyadi, it will be in the same solid state, dry kane untadi. There will not be any volume change. So if I add 9%, apur koda dry solid state lane untadi. Whereas if I add 11 or 12%, then what happens? It comes to this semi-solid state. So shrinkage limit is the maximum water content up to which there is no reduction in volume of the soil. So the maximum water content. This is more important. In the context, remaining two limits we will be discussing in terms of minimum water content. Okay, so ee shrinkage limit tarvata, okay, so ippudu ee oka dry soil undamma, ee dry soil la ee shrinkage limit tarvata nu emaina oka water content add chey. Okay, suppose nu ippudu 11% water content add chey and then keep it in oven, and then if you observe back, there will not be any shrinkage cracks in this. ఈ సాయిల్లో నువ్వు ఇంకా ఎంత వాటర్ దీనికన్నా మాక్సిమం యాడ్ చేసినా ఆ వాటర్ డ్రై అయ్యే దానివల్ల దర్ విల్ నాట్ బి ఎనీ సిగ్నిఫికెంట్ వాల్యూమ్ రిడక్షన్ అట్ ఆల్ ఎందుకంటే దిస్ ఇస్ వాట్ ఇట్ స్టాండర్డ్ వాల్యూమ్ ఇస్ సో దీని తర్వాత నువ్వు ఎంత వాటర్ యాడ్ చేసి నువ్వు ఓవెన్లో పెట్టినా ఆ వాటర్ డ్రై అయ్యే దానివల్ల దాంతో డ్రై వాల్యూమ్కి ఏం పెద్దగా సిగ్నిఫికెన్స్ లాస్ ఉండదు. Okay, so that is the significance of shrinkage limit. And why to study about the shrinkage limit? Actually, shrinkage limit indirectly indicates whether the soil will swell or not. Okay, so swell shrink behavior ni chadagalante, it is good to observe shrinkage limit. And the soil which has its shrinkage limit between 10% to 30% will swell. Okay, అందుకోసం ష్రింకేజ్ లిమిట్ ఆఫ్ సాయిల్ ని మెషర్ చేయాలి. అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ ఇస్ ప్లాస్టిక్ లిమిట్. సో వాట్ ఇస్ ప్లాస్టిక్ లిమిట్? ప్లాస్టిక్ లిమిట్ అప్పుడు మన సెమీ సాలిడ్ సాయిల్ ఏమైంది? వాట్ ఇస్ ప్లాస్టిక్ లిమిట్? ఇట్ హ్యాస్ రెస్యూమ్డ్ అ మోల్డబుల్ స్టేట్. ఐ మే రైట్? So the soil became a moldable one and it could takes a shape. It will not crumble. Okay. So that's why the experiment is like, take some 30 gram of soil, which is passing through 425 micron, and then roll it into a 3 mm thread. Okay. The water content at which the 3 mm thread will not crumble indicates its plastic limit. Alage kada chadigam. So what is plastic limit then? The minimum water content
minimum water content at which soil sample can
molded into any shape. So the minimum water content at which soil can be molded. Kada? So this is one important thing. So next one is liquid limit. So what is liquid limit? Liquid limit ante enti? The minimum water content so liquid limit ante enti at which soil starts flowing like a liquid. So start flowing like a liquid and it will not take any shear load. Right? So our shear strength almost zero antaru. But if you conduct an experiment on soil at liquid limit, the soil was found to possess a shear strength of tau is equal to 2.7 kilonewton per meter square. Chala takko shear strength undi, but it had some amount of shear strength. Oka soil teeskunnaru, dantla liquid limit la water add chesaru, and then they conducted a test. When shear test, ఒక టెస్ట్ కండక్ట్ చేశారు అండ్ దే ఫౌండ్ దట్ ద షియర్ స్ట్రెంత్ ఆఫ్ సాయిల్ వాస్ అరౌండ్ 2.7 కిలోన్యూటన్ పర్ మీటర్ స్క్వేర్ ఉండిందంట. ఓకే, సో జస్ట్ రిమెంబర్ దిస్ నంబర్. ఓకే, ఇన్ ఫ్యూ ప్లేసెస్ దే విల్ ఆస్క్. ఓకే, సో దీస్ ఆర్ ఆల్ రిగార్డింగ్ లిక్విడ్ లిమిట్. సి, ఐల్ ఆస్క్ యూ అ సింపుల్ క్వశ్చన్ నౌ. సపోజ్ ప్లాస్టిక్ లిమిట్ ఆఫ్ సాయిల్ WP 30% and this punta. In field, the natural water content of soil. So natural ga oka field ade same soil tho natural water content enta undante 38%. Now, what is the state of soil? Idi natural water content in the field. So no just field ki elli edo oka experiment chesa, core cutter chesa, appudu soil collect chestunna vaste సాయిల్ తో వాటర్ కంటెంట్ 38% ఉండిందంట. ప్లాస్టిక్ లిమిట్ టెస్ట్ చేస్తే 30% వచ్చిందంట. సో నౌ టెల్ మీ వాట్ ఇస్ ద స్టేట్ ఆఫ్ సాయిల్. దిస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ క్వశ్చన్స్ ఆర్ ఆస్క్డ్. సాయిల్ ఇప్పుడు ఏం స్టేట్ లో ఉంటది?
సెమీ సాలిడ్.
లిక్విడ్
సాయిల్ ఇస్ ఇన్ విచ్ స్టేట్? 30% గ్రాఫ్ లో ఎక్కడమా ఉంటది? వేర్ షుడ్ ఐ రైట్ దిస్ 30%? దిస్ ఇస్ ద 30% నో, ఇక్కడ ఉంది. సో వేర్ ఇస్ 38%? ఆఫ్టర్ 30% ఏ కదా 38% ఉంటది, అప్పుడు ఇక్కడ ఉంటది సమ్వేర్ హియర్. వాట్ ఇస్ ద స్టేట్ ఆఫ్ సాయిల్?
ప్లాస్టిక్
స్టేట్. సో ప్రొవైడెడ్ యువర్ లిక్విడ్ లిమిట్ ఇస్ గ్రేటర్ దాన్ 38%. సో లిక్విడ్ లిమిట్ ఒకవేళ 50% అని తీసుకుంటాం, దెన్ ఐ క్యాన్ క్లైమ్ దట్ దిస్ ఆయిల్ ఇస్ ఇన్ ప్లాస్టిక్ స్టేట్. సో వాట్ ఇస్ ద సిగ్నిఫికెన్స్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ 30? దట్స్ అ మినిమం వాటర్ కంటెంట్. సో ప్లాస్టిక్ స్టేట్ లో ఉండడానికి మినిమం వాటర్ కంటెంట్ 30%. మ్యాక్సిమం అది లిక్విడ్ లిమిట్ కన్నా తక్కువ ఎంతైనా ఉండొచ్చు. సో ఈ 50% బిలో ఎంత ఉన్నా అది ప్లాస్టిక్ స్టేట్ లోనే ఉంటుంది. సిమిలర్లీ ఈ 50% కి పైగా ఎంత ఉన్నా సాయిల్ లిక్విడ్ లిక్విడ్ కండిషన్ లోనే ఉంటది. ఓకే, సో కుడ్ యు అండర్స్టాండ్? హలో,
సో
దట్ ఇస్ వై ఐఎమ్ ఎంఫసైజింగ్ ద వర్డ్ మినిమం. ఓకే, so now we will see few indices in relation to this consistency limits. So the first index is plasticity index. So what is plasticity index? Hello, so plasticity index means the water content or the range of water content at which the soil will exist in plastic state. Okay, so plasticity index ante enti, a range lo soil plastic state lo exist ayyidi, so that range of water content is known as plasticity index. సో మన కేసులో చూసామంటే ఇక్కడ ఏం చెప్పాను, ప్లాస్టిక్ లిమిట్ 30% చెప్పాను, లిక్విడ్ లిమిట్ ఏమో 50% చెప్పాను. సో హౌ మచ్ ఇస్ యువర్ ప్లాస్టిసిటీ ఇండెక్స్? అండ్ వీ రిప్రజెంట్ ప్లాస్టిసిటీ ఇండెక్స్ బై ద లెటర్ ఐపి. సో నౌ టెల్ మీ హౌ మచ్ ఇస్ యువర్ ప్లాస్టిసిటీ ఇండెక్స్?
30
WL మైనస్
WP.
సో మన కేసులో అయితే 50 - 30, విచ్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు 20%. సో ప్లాస్టిసిటీ ఇండెక్స్ ఇస్ 20%. సో ఇఫ్ ద సాయిల్స్ వాటర్ కంటెంట్ ఎగ్జిస్ట్ ఎనీవేర్ బిట్వీన్ 30 to 50, దెన్ ఓన్లీ ఇట్ విల్ ఎగ్జిస్ట్ ఇన్ ప్లాస్టిక్ కండిషన్. ఓకే, సో దట్ ఈస్ రిగార్డింగ్ ప్లాస్టిసిటీ ఇండెక్స్. సో నౌ we'll see what is liquidity index. What is liquidity index? So liquidity index is represented by the letter IL. okay, so liquidity index then chuttundi, so this indicates range, or I can say plastic range. And what is liquidity index? So liquidity indicates, so index ante emma, hello, what is index? If you buy a book, there is an index. So index ante enti?
Range.
Range or indicator ani cheppochu kada. So index is something which indicates the parameters or properties. Okay, liquidity index ante liquid state ki nearness ni indicate chestadi. So liquidity index represents nearness to liquid state. So how to represent liquidity index? So IL is equal to natural water content of the soil in the field minus WP divided by WL minus WP into 100. So oka soil tho water content meeku telustundi. Okay, so you will get it in terms of percentage. Okay, so meeku oka soil field lo undi, and after coming to lab you could measure its water content. So suppose if you are getting its water content as 42%, so just water content ochinante, so by keeping it in hot air oven you could measure its water content. So water content matra telusukoni em chesedi, is it closer to its liquid state or is it closer to its plastic state? Nothing, you know, right? So once you conduct all the liquid limit plastic limit test and all, you can at least predict their plastic limit, liquid limit, those things. But still సో ఇది లిక్విడ్ ఇండెక్ లిక్విడ్ స్టేట్కి దగ్గర ఉందా లేదంటే ప్లాస్టిక్ స్టేట్కి దగ్గర ఉందా అని నాకు ఇంకా ఒక క్లియర్ పిక్చర్ కావాలి. దెన్ యూ క్యాన్ గో ఫర్ లిక్విడిటీ ఇండెక్స్. ఓకే, సో దట్ యూ క్యాన్ ఫైండ్ అవుట్ ఇస్ ఇట్ హౌ క్లోజ్ ద వాటర్ కంటెంట్ టు లిక్విడ్ స్టేట్. ఓకే, సో ద ఫార్ములా ఇస్ డబ్ల్యూ మైనస్ డబ్ల్యూపీ డివైడెడ్ బై WL minus WP into 100. Okay, so suppose now the question is, if natural water content in field is at liquid limit, సో సపోజ్ మన లాస్ట్ కేస్ ప్రకారం చూడాలంటే ఇప్పుడు లాస్ట్ కేసులో ఎంతమ్మా డబ్ల్యూపీ ఏమో 30% చెప్పాము అండ్ డబ్ల్యూఎల్ ఇస్ 50%. ఓకే, సో హియర్ న్యాచురల్ వాటర్ కంటెంట్ విచ్ ఇస్ మెషర్డ్ ద ఫీల్డ్ డబ్ల్యూ ఇస్ 50%, అప్పుడు దాని లిక్విడిటీ ఇండెక్స్ ఎంత ఉంటుంది? హౌ మచ్ ఇస్ ఇట్స్ ఐఎల్? హలో, can you tell me how much is its liquidity index? Natural water content in the field itself is at liquid limit. Now tell me, are you guys there?
Hundred percent.
So when the natural water content is at liquid limit, then liquidity index will be 100%. Kada endukante nearness to liquid state lone undi, appudu enta close ga undi, 100% closer. Okay, so that is what regarding liquidity index. Next one is consistency index, or otherwise I can say IC. So IC is actually consistency index indicates how consistent the soil is. Okay, and it indicates nearness of water content to plastic state. So plastic state ki enta degira manam unnam. Okay, so to predict that we can use consistency index, and consistency index is mathematically given as IC is equal to WL minus W divided by WL minus WP. Here W ante field water content or natural water content, okay, into 100. Now tell me, if the natural water content existing at the field, okay, so natural ga entha undante 30%. Okay, natural water content is 30%. Now tell me, how much is its consistency index? So for our same case, WP 30% and WL 50%. Would you tell me?
Hundred
percent. So consistency index is 100%. Okay, always remember that if the consistency index is greater than 100%. Okay, so if consistency index is greater than 100%, how the soil will be, how the water content of the soil will be, or how the nature of soil will be? If consistency index is greater than 100%, how the soil is?
Liquid.
if it is greater than 100%, IC value is greater than 100%. IC 100 రావాలంటే ఎంత ఉండాలి వాటర్ కంటెంట్? W must be equal to WP కదా. సో IC is equal to WL minus WP divided by WL minus WP వేస్తేనే మీకు 100 వస్తుంది కదా. దిస్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ విల్ గివ్ యూ 100%. So if you need an IC greater than 100%, then how the value of W will be? W value ento undali? It must be
greater than 30.
Greater than 30.
Less than WP.
Less than WP. Very good. See, if it is greater than 30, malli numerator lo chinna takku vastadi kada. See ma. WL minus 30, numerator 50 minus 30 divided by denominator again 50 minus 30. So up to here, as we got the answer 100%. Okay, the cancel like this, so 1 also the 100%. So if I reduce the value in numerator, then what happens? I will get some percentage less than 100, but I'm not asking that. If IC is greater than 100%, then what happens? WP, so your natural water content is less than WP. Kada appudu soil em state lo untadi? Your natural water content existing in the field is less than plastic limit, then how the soil will exist? Shall we go back to this figure?
Semi-solid or solid?
Semi-solid or solid state. Okay, so IC value greater than 100% unte semi-solid or solid state. That's why I told consistency index indicates firmness or consistence of the soil. Okay, so greater than 100 utta endi chaala ba gattiga undi. It is more firm, right? And regarding here, you have to remember a relationship that always consistency index plus liquidity index is equal to 100%. Okay, just make a note of this relationship. So if you submit consistency index and liquidity index, you will get 100%. Okay. Next one is flow index. So flow index actually indicates the rate at which the soil loses its shear strength once you add water. See, a dry soil is there, especially a cohesive or fine grain soil is there, and the moment you keep on adding water, the shear strength of soil decreases. Okay, and the flow index indicates rate at which shear strength of the soil decreases with increasing water content. Okay, so now this flow index is actually the slope of flow curve. What is flow curve? So flow curve is nothing but a graph which was drawn at the end of your liquid limit test. At the x-axis, you have to take number of flows on log scale. Kada? And whereas on the y-axis, water content will be there. See, if I add water content, ela graph increase outundante, suppose starting 5, 10, 15. Okay. Likewise, it is increasing. Now tell me, if the water content is very high, then am I need to give more number of blows or less number of blows to make
less the number of flow?
Very less number of flows. So water content chala ekku unte easy gaane flow start aipoyiddi in your Casagrande apparatus. So you need very less number of blows. Okay. So for high water content you need less number of blows. Whereas if your soil contains very less amount of water content, then you need to give more number of blows to make it to flow. Kada? So this is how your flow curve will be. So if I take slope of this curve, then I will get flow index IF. Okay. So IF is nothing but slope of this curve. So how to write slope of this curve? So suppose here a water content is there. Okay, and here another water content is there. Shall we take it as W1, W2, and correspondingly here this is N1, and here the number of flows as N2. Okay. So how to take the slope? Slope ela mostadi straight line ki delta y by delta x, right?
W1 minus W2 by N1 minus N.
It is in log scale, right?
Log n.
Log 10 N2 by N1. Actually here N1 minus N2 is the a negative sign will come up. That's why we have mentioned it like N2 by N1. Okay. So this gives me flow index. If this flow curve is very steep, chala steep ground in the nuko, the rate of decrement of shear strength will also be in a faster rate. Okay, chala thoraka shear strength tagipoyidi water add chesetappudu. Whereas if this curve is a flat one, so flat ga unte shear strength easy ga tagadu. Okay, so steep curve will have more loss of shear strength with respect to addition of water, whereas here less loss of tau value, less loss of shear strength. Okay, curve flat ga unte less shear strength tagithi. Okay. And last topic for today's session is toughness index. So toughness index. So how will we represent toughness index? So toughness index is represented by the letter IT. Okay, and the toughness index is nothing but the ratio of plasticity index divided by flow index. Okay, and this toughness index is used to measure shear strength of soil at plastic limit. So at plastic limit, how much is it shear strength? Okay. And listen, generally shear strength of soil at plastic limit will be 100 times the shear strength of soil at liquid limit. It is an approximate relationship. Okay. So just remember this relationship also. And beyond everything, I just clarify something. If water content of a soil is 30%, so and it is in a plastic state, it is always not necessary that so soil 1 okati undama and soil 2 is there, and at 30% water content this soil is in plastic state. Okay, appudu soil 2 which is taken from some other site B lo nunchi techamo, idi site A soil. Okay, for soil 2 at 30% water content, it may not be at plastic state. Okay, so universal ga anni soil 30% water content vachaka plastic limit ayyadani cheppalem. Okay, could you understand? So the plastic limit is a soil specific thing. So each and every soil which has its own plastic limit, but the behavior of all the soil at plastic limit is same. Arthamavutunda? This soil may be having plastic limit at for example 42% la plastic state avutund anukunta. Plastic limit of this soil is at is 42%. First soil kema 30%. Renditiki vere vere plastic limit undachu, but the behavior of soil at that plastic limit is almost the same. So behavior same untadi. So plastic limit ante appude em behavior aithi, it will be in a moldable state. So alage soil 1 aina soil 2 aina plastic limit tana plastic limit achieve ayyaka moldable state ku vachindi. Same for liquid limit also. So liquid limit vere vere undachu, kaani liquid limit ku vachaka rendu soil same kane behave ayyadi. So here behavior ante em chaala important ante shear strength. So anni soil ki plastic limit appudu almost same shear strength untadi, alage anni soil ki liquid limit appa almost same shear strength e untadi, kani aa limit anedi vere vere undachu. Okay, so that is what I thought to emphasize here. Okay, so